back to my channel. For those who don't know me, my name is Ongez. Why do I feel like you guys are up there and I'm like, I don't know. But anyway, I'll check. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For those who don't know me, my name is Ongez, but you can call me CT Mom because I am a mother of three handsome boys. Someone once said, why do you say your, I think it was a friend, I don't remember who said, why do you say your kids are handsome? We must tell you that your kids are handsome. And in my head, I'm like, I don't need anyone to tell me that my kids are handsome. I know they are. I tell them every day that you are a very cute, handsome man. I don't need anyone to tell me like, hey bo, kona umzali othi umntana akhe mbi guys. But anyway, to my new subbies, thank you so much for joining the family. If you've been here, thank you so much for the love and support. Really appreciate it. I have a glass of wine. Today we're gossiping, guys. Literally. One thing I love is the fact that I now have a family on YouTube. Like, YouTube is my safe space. Yo, ngiyadlala, guys. But I just love the fact that I have a YouTube channel. It is so nice. Like, yeah, it is very, very nice. And today we're gossiping. And I want to gossip about... you guys, remember these dates that I told you? I want to start going on dates. Why ningangibuza ukuthi idate yami nase Cape Town ihambe kanjani? Why? Why ningangibuza? But anyway, I'm not gonna talk about that date. I don't wanna talk about that guy. Actually, he is very blocked. Very much blocked. Akasekho efonini yami. Block, delete. Ngiyaphuma emabhuzini. But anyway, guys, I actually wanna talk about this because I feel like I don't know whether because you come with kids, people expect you to lower your standards, you know. I don't know. And also, I'm very interested in knowing to the young ones, you know, more 25, 24, let's say 25 upwards, you know, 25, 26, 27, if you're like looking for someone or like you're not in a relationship, right? You're trying to get into dating and just, you know. How is it going for you guys, especially if you don't have a child? For those who don't have kids, you don't have a child, and like you come with, I don't want to call my kids baggage, oof, fire, but you come with nothing. Like you just yourself, you're just a lady who's got her things together. You've got your apartment, your car, your whatever, you know, whether you're still at school, it doesn't matter. Material things are not important. But what I'm trying to say here is that you don't have a child, you know. I just want to know, are they treating us differently, and are they treating y'all differently? Because I feel like with us, our age mates, the late 30s to the early 40s, mid 40s, late 40s, I don't know, I just feel like we're going through a lot, and we're just dealing with princesses. Like, men are just princesses now. I don't want to say all men are taken, all good men are taken. No, I'm still hopeful that there is a good man out there for me. But I just feel like the majority of people that we are left with here, they're just princesses. Like, we're left with all princess. When I say princesses, guys, the men that you... okay, you came to me, but now that I'm giving you my attention, you have my number, we're talking and stuff like that. Like, now I have to initiate even conversations sometimes, and I'm like, what the hell is happening? Like, amadoda ngoku guys afuna ucengwa, like afuna ucengwa, afuna ucengwa. Like, I don't know how to explain this, guys. I know there are a lot of people who watch me from outside South Africa, and they always complain that, girl, you know, Venek Kancane, we love your channel and we want to understand, but guys, there are things that you can't say in English. How do I say this? Like, men, they want us to beg them. Like, men of today want us to beg them. Like, they are just princesses. I don't know whether they have it in their heads that men are less, women are a lot, or I don't know what's happening in the dating side. The only thing I know is that it's just a mess. And the way we messing a corner, I'm curious. Like, I would really, really love to hear, or someone else who's not coming with kids, who's just a, you know, I'm a lady, I've got my together, and I just want to date, and like, you know, how are they treating you guys? Because, yo, sana, like, ziyabuya, look, ziyabuya kuthi guys, guys, anyway, let me get to the point. So there's this guy I was talking to. Let me check if this thing is recording. Guys, I'm having wine as well. Grab yourself wine, water, whatever, because we need to gossip about Ab. Guys, I'm shooting this ne, because we don't have a vlog tomorrow. One, two, Luban's sleeping, and I have a big voice. Like, by nature, I have a very big voice, and Luban's is a light sleeper, so it's a mess. But anyway, guys, so let's get to the point. Cape Town, I'm not gonna explain a lot of things about him, but honestly, I don't like people who don't put effort. I don't like disrespectful people. I don't like guys, just put some effort if you want someone or something to work. Like at this point, if you want me, because I mean, it's not a relationship. And then even with the ones that I haven't met, there is this one on the time we went to, and not men, went to the staycation with the ladies. Shabu, I think that was just the last time he spoke to me, because I don't know whether he got annoyed, because all the time when he tries to meet up with me, I'm not available. When I'm available, he's not available. Like, it's always a mess. And remember, I am a mom. I'm a stay-at-home mom. I'm not gonna stop my life just because now I wanna go on dates. I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna stop my life. But should I have time available to squeeze you in, then definitely I'll do that. So he kept on trying, but also the communication is bad. And I don't know, that day he said, can we do dinner? I was like, no, we can't do dinner. Can we do lunch rather? Because at night we have, we planned a pajama party with the ladies. So night is just not gonna work. So let's do lunch, right? And then he said, actually, I have a meeting during the day, because he doesn't stay in Joburg. So it's like, no, actually, I have some couple of things that I need to do, attend to during the day. So around about 6-7, I'll be available. I'm like, nope. Excuse me. At that time, I'm not available because of 1-2-3. That was the last time Muka spoke to me. He was like, oh, okay, sharp. What Puma mean? At this point, I'm like, guys, what's happening? Like, what am I supposed to do? I can't stop my life. I really cannot stop my life. And my friends are also busy. I know because my friends do help me out with the baby when I need to. Not like go to dates only, but they help me with other things, like important things. If I'm like, your friend, I need to do something and I can't go with Lubans. I need to go to an interview and I can't go with Lubans. Whatever that I need to attend that is very, very important and I can't go with Lubans. My friends do come through for me. But I'm not gonna always ask them to do those things for me, especially when it's not that important, you know? Like, I've already told you that I have kids. And there is this one who still needs my attention a lot. So I'm not gonna drop everything, you know, for my dates, you know. But my point here is that we are just dealing with princesses that men, they just don't care. They don't care, abandoned daba, they're not putting effort, they just like. And if they do put effort, they'll put effort up until they can get you. And then after that, we're back to square one. We're just back to Uguti, okay, now we are in a relationship. If we're in a relationship and I'm not gonna continue pursuing you the way I was pursuing you, I'm not gonna continue putting the effort that I was putting at the beginning. Like, there's just something wrong in the dating. I don't know if I should call it dating industry, but there's just something off. I just want to come here and ask, like, the young ones, you know, if you hear on my channel. Actually, I know I do have young ones on my channel. Are you guys experiencing the same thing? Because Mina, sometimes I feel like I'm experiencing this, or I'm currently going through this, because I don't know, maybe people feel like you should lower your standards, because you know, you already have three kids. And one thing about men, when you tell them you have kids, they will ask you, hey bo, you have three kids? Yes, I have three kids. Were you married before? Hey bo. So I can't have three kids because I was never married. So three kids is for married people. Oh, you were never married. Oh, okay. Three kids. So, do they have one father? Hey, so do they have one father? No, each child has this, their own father. Yo, guys, what I mean, guys, nangiphumile because no, it's like, hey, all of them have their own fathers. Yes, what happened? Why? Oh no, the first one was an early teenage pregnancy. The second one, the third one. Oh, okay, no, that's fine. That's fine. You're so beautiful. You don't look like a person who has three kids. How, guys? I want one at three kids, manja. You don't look like a person who has three kids. Oh, you're so beautiful. Oh, okay. Oh, thank you. I get a conversation, and at this point, you don't know whether this person is continuing with the conversation because they want to, or like, you don't know. But if there's something I'll never do now is hide my kids. It's someone. There's a friend of mine who once said, "Ongezo, stop telling men you have three kids and stop telling them that they all come from three different baby daddies at a go." Like, don't do that, like in a talking stage. Don't do those things. Tell them when they it's serious, 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 serious. Say deep, 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 deep. I'm like, there's no way I'm gonna get that deep with someone without them knowing everything about me. No, I'm not that person. I don't want to surprise someone and make you fall in love with me or like me even more because I didn't tell you the truth about me or my life. And that's another thing. I'm not ashamed of my kids. I'm not ashamed of having kids, and I was never married. That's one thing I'm not ashamed of, and that's why I can't hide it. It is literally the first thing that comes out of my mouth. If you want to know me, like, if you want to know me, I'm a mom, I'm a mother to three handsome boys. That's the first thing you should know. So if we're not there, ufuna ukwazi ukuthi ngangishadile before, ngibathole kanjani, how did I get to three baby daddies? Sana, I'll give you all the details if that's what you want. Because now I know a man who really, really loves me, who's looking for my heart and not what I come with, will not be bothered by all those things. So I cannot keep quiet and not share and wait until the relationship or no, I'm not that person. And I told that girl, I was like, friend, I'm not that person. I can't do that. I cannot lie because for me, it feels like I'm lying. But anyway, this is not gonna be long, guys. And I just wanted to find out, guys, what is happening in the dating industry because it is the ghetto. It's the ghetto. It's the pits. It's just, I don't know, guys. It's just a mess. Like, men these days are not making an effort. You know, when I went to Cape Town, I mean, pick me up with a bouquet of flowers, do something. You know, there's just no effort. That guy made no effort, none, zero effort on anything. Like, literally nothing. Like, I'm that girl who expects you to, when you pick me up at the airport, have flowers in your hands. And another thing is that we're not asking things that we've never experienced. We're not asking for things that we've never seen. Zenzeka, and you're like, oh, this is so beautiful. I want this for myself. You know, I have a friend of mine, Uavela. She's married in and she stays in Durban. Like, guys, I have friends all over the country. I have a friend, and the thing is, Lana, the way beyenza ngakhona, I was like, wow. You know, this is so beautiful. And I was like, oh, Gandhi, nam, new standard. And Umyenwake used to tell me, when you're not married, multi date, don't put your into one person up until you find the person who's serious, 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 serious about you. And we are born now, okay, lona ke ufuna ukushada. You know, like when we used to work at that mine, her husband, boyfriend then, no fiance then, when he picks us up at the airport, he will come with flowers. When we get to the house, he has this whole setup and it's so beautiful, it's so nice, it's so romantic, you know? And that's why I'm always like, the things that we are looking for, it's not that they're not there. We are seeing other ladies. You know, and some of the things I experienced them myself when I was young, and now I'm thinking maybe I'm not experiencing those things because maybe now I don't have one child, and maybe a person feels like I don't deserve such things. And I'm like, no, darling, I know my worth. And I know kuthiwa ke phaka kwano your worth, it's very lonely. It's okay, I'll continue being the person that I am until I get someone who is looking for my heart, because this nonsense that I'm currently dealing with right now, I'm actually back to zero, to not chatting to anyone. I'm back to zero. I am back to, there is no one, absolutely no one I am talking to. Good try again. But also, it's not that I don't want to, like, abafana guys bahlezi bekhona here and there chatting your DMs, you know, they're always there, but you get to a point of like, do I really want to continue giving these people a chance, talking to them? Because I feel like it's just messed up. It is so messed up. And Cape Town just made me to be like, you know what? It's not worth it. Like, put effort. Like, just put some effort. You can't be coming to pick me up at the airport. You don't even have flowers. Like, put some effort into this thing, you know? Like, I was like, oh, if I could sit and share everything that happened, guys, and what happened after, even when I came back, I was like, you know what, guys, let's just be honest. We are dealing with princesses, men who want us to follow them, men who want us to text. Yes, I know they say, if indodiyakuthanda izokulandelela, maybe I haven't found lo mntu lowo obonayo uba makaphuthe i-effort kum. Maybe andamfumani. Because at this point, I'm just getting people who get annoyed, not necessarily get annoyed, but who are just not patient enough to understand that I'm not going to stop my life. Like, literally, I'm a mom, and motherhood to me comes first. Then the rest follows, right? My kids come first, then the rest follows. So I'm not gonna drop my kids so that I can attend to indoor. I need a man who's gonna understand that, can I just be a mom to my kids, make sure my kids are happy, make sure my kids are safe, my kids are like, let me just make sure that my kids are but right, then I can attend to you, because there is no point of me leaving the house if my kids are not happy, they don't want me to leave, there's no one to look after them, and you know, all those things. So I don't know whether I'm getting immature people who just don't understand. They think they're matured, but they're actually not matured. They think that they understand that it's okay to date someone with kids, but they actually don't understand, because their actions will show. I mean, that guy, just because I said I can't do dinner at nights, let's do lunch, because he couldn't understand. He was like, no, but now you know, it's usually hard for you because of the baby, but now you're not in the house, you at staycation in Branston with the ladies, so it's easy for you to do whatever. And I was like, yes, it's easy for me to do whatever now because I'm weekend away from abantu endlini, but still we have plans with the ladies. I can't drop the ladies so that I can meet a man. Like, guys, I'm a daughter. I don't know, guys, but that's my gossiping for this vlog. And to be honest, I don't know if I want to continue. I don't know, man. I'll see. I just needed to update you guys on the dating thing that I've started, and it's not looking good, and I'm not gonna lower my standards, and yeah, I'm just not gonna lower my standards, and I know what I want, and I know what I want is available. It is out there. I just haven't found it. I haven't met the person, and yeah, for now, I'm not even gonna say I'm gonna put it on pause, because I know myself. Once I tell myself I'm doing this, I am still in the I wanna meet someone, you know, but I don't think I'm actively doing it like I was before, because I'm just like, I don't have time. I don't have the time and energy to be explaining small things like my life, you know, this is how my life is, this is how my life is set up. I don't have that time. If I tell you once, I expect you to hear me when I'm talking, and I'm not gonna repeat myself, yabo. And if you don't have the patience, you won't linda, then it's fine. You know, go find a lady who doesn't have a child, need date, you know. But yeah, it is what it is. And I've blocked Cape Town, he's not on my dimplokile, because something happened and I was like, really, are you that guy? Really, this is what you do? So I was like, let me just remove this person from my content list. Like, it was a nice trip. I enjoyed going to Cape Town. It was nice. I thought he's a potential boyfriend up until I got to meet him, and I was like, maybe not. No, I was like, no, actually, because nah, guys, one thing I would always say that is that I'm not even impressed by money. Like, money doesn't impress me. I'm impressed by a kind man. I love a kind-hearted person. A person who's got humanity, a person who's, oh, I love a kind man. Oh, I love, so I'm just that person. Like, guys, you've got everything. Like, money doesn't impress me. Like, you can have all the money in the world, sana, but if I'm not my manners, cut. You know, so yeah, I was like, hey, let me just keep it moving, because I guess Anna is to lower my standard, and also is to, I'm not gonna be disrespected by umtu, and umtu like disrespect, and yes, but also be tata piland ba disrespect. Like, who do you think you are? Or one and indo nimna, I don't deserve your respect, you know. So it was just one of those things where I'm like, no, not my type. Not my type. Guys, Mina, you can be my type physically. You're my type, man. Until you open your mouth. And I'm like, let's keep it moving. So, no, I love kind men. Oh, ndoda nobuntu, guys. Indoda nobuntu, indoda nenhliziyo enhle, indoda emaziyo umuntu, indoda emsabayo uNkulunkulu. Yo. And guys, ke wonke lamadoda athi anjalo, athi ayamsaba uNkulunkulu, wonke athi ayathandaza, ahamba isonto, wonke lamadoda Nkosi yami uvela ubone ba tick 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 up until you start date. Yo. Yabona mase ningena deep into conversation. Guys, umuntu uyamuzwa ku conversation ukuthi ayikhona. Le, no, you're not a gentleman. Guys, yo, up my gentleman. Like, mna guys, I just want simple love, simple things. Like, go to ice cream dates. You know, you don't have to. I know, babantu bazothi, I want you to book the most expensive hotel or no restaurant. Dun. Oh, sana, I'm a simple girl. Just say, baby, unga drive and I'm gonna come pick you up, and then we're gonna go for ice cream date. You know, I'm that girl. I'm a simplest girl ever. Like, little things impress me. Little things make me happy. Little things. Like, no one impressing imali, because, I mean, like, come on. It's money. Like, relax. Calm down. You know? Like, just little things. They make me so happy. But yeah, I think this is enough. Let me take off this dress and join my son in bed, because he's a light sleeper. I'll post this tomorrow. I just wanted to gossip that, guys, it's not going well. It's not looking good on the dating dontoni. And I don't know, men are just disrespecting us. I don't know whether it's because, I don't know, if you're a mom and you also dating, please tell me, how is it going for you? Because sometimes I honestly feel like I'm being disrespected because I have kids, and you feel like I'm not looking for a father. Like, I'm not looking for the father of my kids. My kids have their fathers. I am not looking for someone who will financially support my kids. Another thing, men think that when you want to date after you have kids, you're looking for someone who will be a father to your kids. I don't want a person who will be a father to my kids. My kids have their fathers, and their fathers are responsible fathers. There are fathers who are there in their lives. My kids have relationships with their fathers. I'm not looking for someone who's going to come and be a father to my kids. My kids are okay. I'm not looking for that. I'm not... Guys, I would need... And you need to explain all those things. No, the fathers are financially supporting them. You know, like where do you fit in? What my baby daddies are doing and not doing? Why are you interested in that one? Why can't you just concentrate on me? Because it's me that you want. Forget about my kids. My kids are okay. They are covered. Sana, dating in late 30s, dating when you have kids, it's the pits. Like, I don't know if I want to continue. I don't know if I'm fit enough for this, because one thing about me, I'm very, very stubborn. If there's one thing I know, men always tell me, wutongas, we are very stubborn, and I'm becoming more stubborn now, because I'm like, I'm not gonna lower my standard just to be in a relationship. I'm not gonna lower my standard just for me to defeat her, boyfriend. I'm not gonna do that. I am not gonna do that. I'm not gonna lower my standard for anyone. Up until the person who feels good to know, this is what I've been looking for, and we settle down. But Leoba, I must take all the nonsense just because now, guys, that's why I'm like, if you are 20 something and you are dating, guys, please share how is the dating don't going on your side. Like, are your guys being treated like queens? You know, how is it going? Because on our side, late 30s, I get the katek. I can't be that. But guys, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys on Sunday. On my Sunday vlog. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope you guys didn't skip the ads. And I am definitely gonna show you guys my next paycheck so that we see Uguti. Are you guys watching the ads or not? I'm getting paid 4,000. Have you guys moved me from that 4,000 or not? And I'm gonna show you guys. Like I said, we are transparent here, and we're gonna continue having family meetings until you guys do right by me. But for now, we're having a family gossip, because your city mom is going through it all. So yeah, kulungile, goodbye. See you on my next one. Bye. I want you a symphony. Just to say how much you mean to me. Would you?